In this video, I show you how to cut videos in Shotcut. Hi everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I show you how to use open source software. Today, we're going to look at cutting videos in Shotcut. So let's head straight over to the computer. There are three key ways to trim and cut videos in Shotcut, and what I'm going to do right now is go through each one of them. Depending on your situation and the end result that you're wanting, depend on which one you want to use. So the first one is trimming the beginning or end of a video after you drag it into Shotcut. So the way I use Shotcut is that I put everything into my playlist before I edit it. I would recommend that you do the same thing. And the first thing I'm going to do is drag my video clip into the playlist. And then sometimes when you open the video, it can preview in this pane, but what you don't get are any options around here. So if I double click, I actually get some additional options here. So make sure you've double clicked on the playlist item. And then here you've got a little arrow and you can drag that inwards. What that's going to do, it's going to ignore this part of the video, trim it to this section here. I'm going to play the blue bit, and then you use this arrow on the other side to go inwards. It's going to ignore this last section as well. So instead of it being an 8-second video, it's now just a 4-second video. Now that's almost set up like a template file. So now when you drag it into the timeline, it's only going to give you the section that you've created from that trimming tool. That's particularly helpful if you wanted multiple versions of your cropped clip in your full video. So that's the very first way of trimming your videos at the beginning and ends. The second way is very similar actually. If we drag in a second video, and I'm going to create a new track just to show you the three different ways. We'll have three different tracks. So I'm going to drag the whole thing without editing it into the timeline. And now that's the video. And what I can do, very similar to method one, is use the bars to click and drag and reduce video size. Now, what that's going to do is this clip will now just show the clip that you've reduced it to. But if you drag in the chess one again, it's going to be the whole thing. So this one is good for individual snips, and option one is good for repeated snips. Now the third option is maybe slightly more advanced. It gets into a little bit more editing, but actually it's the most versatile. So let's create another video track to go through it and drag in another video. So I'm going to drag Elephant straight down to here, and as you can see, it's a bit longer, so it allows me to demonstrate a little bit better on this video. So now let's imagine, instead of wanting to trim the end of the video, we actually want to get rid of the middle parts. So we don't want this section of the video. We're going to click this button here where we want it to stop, which is called split at playhead. And if you wanted to use keyboard shortcut, then that's S on the keyboard, and you click it. And what happens is it will now allow you to use the video parts separately, but you've still got the whole thing in the timeline. Let's say that we wanted to cut it about here. You just click the S button again, and now, again, you've got multiple cuts of the same clip. Let's imagine that we wanted to remove this bit. You can do two things. You can click delete on the keyboard, which will just remove it and leave a gap in the video. Or you've got the option, if I do an undo, you've got the option of selecting it and clicking this minus button, or use the X on the keyboard. What that will do is it will squish it up. So this part here will go back as far as this video section here, and this will be removed. So let me click it, and hopefully that will make sense. It will basically get removed and everything will ripple up to the end. I just undo that once more and I move this over to here, and if I remove that once more, it doesn't move it all the way, it doesn't snap it to the next video. it removes the length of the video that was existing. Okay, so that's particularly helpful. If you still wanted to move this up to the next bit, then you can also right click and do remove, and it will then bunch it up to the next video part. And you can obviously do that as much as you want to in Shotcut and edit your videos as you need to. So you've got lots of options on how to edit and cut your videos. And as I've said, bear in mind option one if you want to do a repeat of each thing, option two if it's just on the fly, and then option three if it's a bit more advanced and you've got quite a bit going on in your video clips. I hope that's been helpful, so please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.